Today we will talk about how to dominate our emotions, emotional intelligence. After a long period of exaltation in the Western world of the value of rational intelligence, of the IQ, a new complementary and even more important value for life has emerged. That of emotional intelligence. I am José Manuel García-Lomas and Allen-Perkins. We all know people who are dominated by emotions, who are emotionally unstable, where anger, fear, sadness, surprise, nervous, bad mood, contradiction, stress, disgust, in short, negative and uncontrolled emotions take over our will of our actions. There, the uncontrolled emotions in the person guide in many occasions their life in a way out of all control. But we human beings can control, dominate our emotions through our emotional intelligence. Emotions can act in our favor and thus improve our EQ. Recognize our emotions and control them, transforming our negative emotions into positive ones. Emotional quota is a way of interacting with the world, where the person not only takes into account the intelligence capacity, thinking, but also values and consider the other facet of the human soul, which is feeling. Emotional intelligence develops skills in the person who works with it and possesses it as 1. Self-control, control of impulses. 2. Self-consciousness, consciousness of our superior being and our peripheral self. 3. The value of motivation that directs our human acts. Motivation as the final reason for human behavior. 4. The enthusiasm that is transmitted to others and which is the subtle but very effective proof of the truth of our positions, the P of Dapa. 5. Empathy, vital trait of emotional intelligence. 6. Mental agility, the capacity to react correctly. 7. Hope, which is the more than a naive vision that everything will be fine. However, it is the belief that one has the will and has the strength and the means to carry out one's objectives, whatever they may be. From an emotional quota point of view, hope means that one does not give in to anxiety, defeating or depression when encountering difficulties and setbacks. 8. Compassion, strongly connected with empathy. 9. Altruism. 10. Perseverance, persistence, which as Calvin Coolidge, president number 30 of the United States, said, nothing in the world can replace persistence. Talent will not. Nothing is more common than unsuccessful men with great talent. Genius will not. The unrewarded genius is almost a proverb. Education will not. The world is full of educated derelicts. Persistence, determination alone, they are almost omnipotent. 11. Optimism. 12. A positive attitude toward life. The question now is how to develop, how to foster, how to strengthen, how to care for our emotional intelligence. Emotional intelligence integrates mind and emotion. Today there is a new vision of excellence in the well-educated person. the integral development of the human being, of the human soul, through the instrumentation that we all have incorporated in our being and that is given to us from birth. Thinking, feeling, and willing, the operating will. The human soul is tripartite. That is to say, it has in first place a think located in the head and all the nerve endings which cover our organism. In second place, it has the feeling which affects everything that is rhythmic and metabolic in our organism. Thirdly, it has the will, which is expressed in the human being by the arms and legs that are the expression of the operating will, the will. A well-educated person acts in the following way. First, he thinks something up using his reasoning faculty with the thinking. Then that thought is lowered to the feeling, receiving information different from the thinking, but enormously valid. Because the logic of feeling is different but of great value to the logic of thinking, feeling permeates and gives worth to cold thinking. And if I think something and I feel that this something is correct and convenient to do, then the intention arises which slips between the feeling and the willing, and I make the decision to bring down my thinking and my feeling to the will, to the operating will, and I realize my thinking and feeling with my will. Therefore, action in a well-educated person goes from thinking to feeling and to willing, to will, to the real world of action, because this world is a world of action. The human being learns more from his failures than from his successes. Rudyard Kipling, in his universal poem, If, Yes, says, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two imposters just the same, the question now is, how do we approach the future? And the answer is by integrating our thinking, feeling, and willing, and in that order. I mean, with our rational intelligence, with our emotional quota, and with our operating will. I would like to remind you that our YouTube channel is about leadership, motivation, negotiation, planning, advanced sales techniques, verbal and nonverbal communication, teamwork, problem solving, human behavior training, and many, many more topics. If you are interested in our videos, I suggest you give a like and subscribe to our channels in Spanish and in English, since we publish videos every week.